The U.S. and Britain seeking for Russia's suspension from the United Nations Human Rights Council following Moscow's apparent war crimes in Ukraine. Washington's ambassador to the U.N. says Russia should have no place there since it may suggest they have legitimate concerns about human rights. She adds Moscow's participation in the council is a farce which only hurts the credibility of the U.N. body. The UK's foreign minister agrees Russia cannot be a member of the council given strong evidence of war crimes in Bucha. A vote on Russia's suspension from the UN Human Rights Council could be held this week. The haunting images of Russia's atrocities in Ukraine deepening Moscow's isolation. Aside from the suspension from the UN Rights Council, more sanctions loom against Russia, with the U.S. saying some of it will be energy-related measures. U.S. President Joe Biden also calling for even tougher actions against his Russian counterpart, Vladimir Putin.
You may remember I got criticized for calling Putin a war criminal. Well, the truth of the matter is so what happened in Bucha. This warrants him, he is a war criminal. But we have to gather the information. We have to continue to provide Ukraine with the weapons they need to continue the fight. And we have to gather all the detail so this can be an actual, have a war crime trial. This guy is brutal. And what's happening in Bucha is outrageous. And everyone's seen it.
Some European countries, including France and Germany, have also expelled dozens of Russian diplomats as evidence mount over Moscow's mass execution of civilians. Ukrainian President Volodymyr Zelensky visits Bucha after mass graves were discovered from the freed Ukrainian city. He says negotiations with Russia will become very difficult given the gravity of Moscow's cruelty. He also expects to discover more casualties as Russia pulls back from other cities. The Ukrainian government has opened an investigation into what Russian forces did during their occupation of Bucha.
The horrors that we've seen in Bucha are just a tip of the iceberg of all the crimes that have been committed by Russian army in the territory of Ukraine so far. And I can tell you without an exaggeration, but with great sorrow, that the situation in Mariupol is much worse.
Russia still bent on denying it committed war crimes in Ukraine. Russia's ambassador to the United Nations again called the images from Bucha fake and produced by Ukrainian radicals. He also showed footage which supposedly proves Russia has not committed any atrocities.
4 days after the Russian military left the city of Bucha, there was not a single sign of atrocities. I repeat, not a single reference to it anywhere. The infamous video depicting bodies on the city roads only appeared on April 3rd. It is full of discrepancies and blatant lies. We have factual evidence that proves this point. We intend to present it to Security Council as soon as possible, so that the international community is not misled by the false narrative promoted by Kyiv and its Western sponsors.